Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here just after 10 o'clock in Honolulu, 4 o'clock in New York. It is Friday. Happy Aloha Friday, as we say on the islands. 21st day of August, 2015, and this is the daily report for gold and silver. Wow. We saw the Dow Jones Industrial Average sell off almost or over 500 points, I should say, today. S&P's dramatic decline, oil dramatic decline. We do have gold trading higher on the day, but in terms of the precious metals, I believe that's the only one, with platinum, silver, and palladium all showing lower pricing on the day. First to gold, up about $5.40. We're looking at COMEX, 1158.60. It's had a low of 48.50 and a high of 67. When we go over into the spot market, 1159, call it, roughly in that area, low 49.14, high 68.32, up approximately $6 on the day. So traders, there is absolutely no doubt we have had one heck of a week, with the equities markets trading off at this point roughly 10% from the top of the market to the current close of the market, and that is in the category of a correction. It's official. Now, when we look at the week in gold, as well as our current trades and support and resistance levels, we believe that positioning ourselves on the long side is the appropriate thing to do. First of all, we are looking at a weekly chart. On this weekly chart, you can see the kind of move that we saw this week, running roughly from what, about 1110 up to these highs above 1160. Another noteworthy feature when we look at this weekly chart is that we can absolutely identify a confirming candle of a three river morning star variation in terms of what we saw this week, in a very, very strong confirmation. Now, first of all, the definition of a three river morning star is following a market decline. We certainly meet that criteria. You get a star which gaps at this point or below this point, meaning the real body of this long red candle, and that would be followed by a long green candle. That would be a pure three river morning star. I am calling this a variation for the following reason. We talked about this pattern developing last week also, and that is, these are really inside trading days. They haven't gapped below the body of this red candle. However, they are at the bottom parts of this green candle, and so the actual three river morning star variation is going to be composed of these 4 weeks of trading right in here. Red candle, double stars, green candle. Your confirming candle would be right here. Of course, this is a long-term study, meaning a weekly chart, but nonetheless, that pattern is holding true to form. We did get confirmation of that. Now, we entered a trade last week. We went long at 1105. We had price orders to get out at 1128. Of course, they were filled. We missed a good portion of the move as it moved up through the night. But as I told you, I am not afraid to buy the dips. I'm also not afraid to buy into a breakout. It was quite evident to me as trading went on overseas on that day that we probably wouldn't get a dip, so we entered the market. We got in at 1152. So we pulled good profits on our first trade this week, and then we re-entered another position that is in the money. So the real question is, what am I looking for in terms of market moves, and most importantly, our support and resistance areas? And to do that, I really need to pull up a much more short-term study. So I draw your attention to the chart I've just put up. It is a half a day standard candlestick chart with moving average, convergence, divergence, MACD. Momentum, very, very strong, no doubt about that. We do have the moving averages moving away from each other, and that, of course, gives you indication of strength in the market. The other way that we look for strength in terms of the trend itself is to look at a Japanese average chart. We'll do that in a second. But that's the first thing that we notice on the MACD. Now, what I really want to do is focus on this chart itself, which is our 720-minute chart. In this chart, we have put a very short-term Fib study from about 1230 down to the bottom of 1071. When we do that, we get certain areas. Now, 1132, the reason we put our price order in at 28 was we felt if it was going to find resistance, it could absolutely find it here. It just barreled through it like a hot knife through butter. We got back in at 52, and that was based upon the fact that it had broken above this 50% retracement line. That was a real breakout to us. Now, support right now, currently at 1150, call it. That's where I'm pegging support, and that's based upon this. Our current level of resistance, short term, of course, is 1170. And 1170, of course, is based on a 61% retracement. And you can see that the market in trading overseas, specifically in Hong Kong, is when this market moved up to these dramatic highs. And then when it went into London is when it kind of softened back up. And this is really the open in New York right in here as it began to trade. So maintain your current long position in gold. In terms of the stop itself, we have it sitting under 32. We might want to consider moving it under 51, maybe 48. That would be a conservative move, but maintain your long gold position. So traders, I want to spend the last few moments of today's weekend review looking at silver. Silver up slightly on the week. You can see that this is a weekly candle, but ever so much. Tremendous highs, tremendous lows. If you recall, when we made a recommendation to buy gold the other day, we did not include silver. The specific reason for that was my belief that if we were going to see a continuation of selling pressure in the equities markets, which we absolutely got, that we would not see silver fare that well. And the basic reason for that is the industrial component of silver, along with platinum and palladium, highly used in industry, and they would succumb to the pressures of lower equity pricing. We saw just that today. As I said, when we look at platinum, platinum traded dramatically lower, down about $15 on the day. When we look at palladium, palladium down about $23 or 3.73%, almost 4% at 600. And finally, silver, silver off a percent and a half down, what, 24 cents, call it, at 1533. Those markets are under pressure. They remain under pressure. We could see a nice upside bounce in those three once we get a bottom in the equities markets and begin to move up off these recent lows that we've hit. And when that will happen really is anyone's guess. Really, we need to look to see what happens Sunday evening in China, because if we get a further dramatic sell-off in China that kind of starts sending it around the world, we could be in for another rocky day in the equities markets come Monday. That, of course, affected the U.S. dollar. U.S. dollar just getting plummeted down over a percent today at 94.89 currently. And it is for those reasons that I want to be long gold. We are, of course, short crude oil in trending markets, and that traders also fell out of bed today. And when we look at what we saw in the crude market, that was off over almost 3%, almost 3%, 2.61%, but it did dip below $40, $39.86 being the low. So we got in the short side of this trade midweek, and we're going to maintain our positions throughout next week. I do believe that crude oil will break below 40, and my initial target is 37, although I think it could go much below that. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. Have a great weekend. We'll talk to you on Monday for another daily update review. Bye-bye.